Hey everyone, welcome to our little mini quick bite module-based talk on data viz, whys, and wins. My name is Nick Fisher, and I am a program evaluator by day and a data viz designer by night. And I help people and organizations turn these kinds of reports that you're probably used to making. They're text heavy, they're using default charts and graphs from software like Microsoft products, Word, Excel, and PowerPoint. And I help organizations and people change those reports over to reports that are more visual, just like this. But here's the trick. The report on the right is designed in PowerPoint. The report on the left is designed in Word. We can make really great data visualizations and report designs in everyday software like PowerPoint, the things that you already know how to use. You don't need any special training, and you don't need to be a graphic designer to really make perfect, beautiful, and effective data designs in your own work. So that's really the message that I want to present to everyone here. And throughout these little modules, I hope that I'm gonna give you some of the, a little bit of the theory theoretical underpinnings behind why data viz is so effective for us, and I'm going to give you some quick wins that anybody can do in their work to make your charts, to make your graphs, to make your reports that much better, okay? So first of all, I want to give a shout out to all the people that I have learned from, all the people that I follow, and these are all the folks that I want you to follow as well. Stephanie Evergreen, Ann Emery, Cole Nussbaumer-Naflick, Echo Rivera, Chris Lissy, and the Data Visualization Society. If you get really nerdy, you can go and become a member of the Data Viz Society. But all of these folks, they have books, they have blogs, they have online courses and communities. I want you all to follow these people in your work. One of the reasons why I love these folks over so many of the other ones that are out there is that they really speak our language. So we are coming from a place where we're working in nonprofits, research and evaluation settings, maybe cultural organizations like museums, zoos, and aquariums like me. And the reason why I gravitate towards these folks so much is because they really, they come from kind of that same universe, and so they speak the same language. And they really are so great at transforming technical information over into non-technical, non-jargony sort of speak, and they really give you a lot of those research-based ways to create better data viz on your own. So I want you to go ahead and follow them. I'm gonna link to all of their resources below in the comments or in the description of this video, and I hope that you will go and follow them. You're gonna see examples that I have learned from and references and citations to their work throughout these modules. So I hope that you'll go ahead and follow them. So why is data viz so important anyway? If you're not going to deliver your report in song, you're probably going to deliver it in some sort of visual medium. So maybe it's a long form report, maybe it's a one pager, an executive summary, or some sort of slide presentation. And so what the data wizards among us will always talk about is the pictorial superiority effect. Basically, what we see takes precedence over all other senses. So what we see, we're going to linger on first, it's going to attract our attention first, and we're going to linger on longer. So it's going to be able to allow us to sort of put what we see into our long-term memory a little bit more. So when it comes to data, I think we could write a sentence like this: guests who attended Keeper Talks during their visit had high overall satisfaction in their visit. I could tell you that all day long. I could write it in a little memo or a report, but once we pair it with some sort of a data visualization just like this, it really brings some life to this statement. And now we can really see, oh yeah, overall satisfaction really was higher for visitors who attended that Keeper Chat than visitors who didn't. So I think this is a really good place to end this little quick bite right here. But in the next section, we're gonna go ahead and talk about some of the theoretical underpinnings behind data visualization and visual processing. Stay tuned.